children, welcome to my class. Today's lesson is Gorilla in the Guest Room. Children, this story is about a man. He owns a zoo and he is going to buy a gorilla. And for few days, it would take some time for him to prepare the staying arrangement for him in the zoo. That's why the gorilla stays in the guest room of the owner or of the owner of the zoo or of the narrator. So let's see what are the naughty things that gorilla does in the room, and how does he look and how does he feel? Yes, the speaker in the text you are about to read has been offered a baby gorilla for his zoo for 1200 pounds. So what is the cost of the gorilla? It is 1200 pounds. Though the zoo is not doing financially well, he cannot resist the idea of adding a gorilla to the zoo. He is not doing very well financially in his zoo, but still he thinks that it will be a very good idea to have a gorilla in the zoo. After many calls to raise the money, he is finally ready to collect the animal. Read on to find out what happened. So let us read, children, this amazing story about the gorilla. The great day came when I went over to the London airport to collect the ape. So where did the narrator go? To the London airport. My one fear was that when I arrived there, it would turn out to be a chimpanzee. So the narrator is wondering, he is fearful about something. What is he fearful about? He is fearful that it could be a chimpanzee. The dealer met me and escorted me to a room in the animal shelter of the Royal Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals. So where did the dealer go? Who is the dealer, children? Dealer is a person who buys and sells goods. So dealer escorted him to a room in the animal shelter of Royal Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals. When the door opened, what did he see? He threw open the door and the first thing I saw was a couple of baby chimpanzees sitting on a table and chewing bananas. So he saw the chimpanzees there, and what were the chimpanzees doing? They were chewing the bananas. Now my heart sank and I had visions of having to go back to Jersey empty-handed. So he is wondering that he will have to go back to Jersey empty-handed. But the dealer walked over to a crate in the corner and opened the door. And Npongo walked into my life. So who walked into the life? Npongo walked into my life. So the name of the gorilla is Npongo. He stood about 18 inches high. So what is the height of the gorilla, children? He is 18 inches high and was quite handsome and was quite most handsome and healthy looking baby gorilla I had ever seen. So the writer is really feeling very happy. The narrator is really feeling very happy to look at the gorilla because he is very healthy looking and handsome. He walked across the room towards me and held up his arms to be lifted up. So this gorilla seems to be a very friendly gorilla. He went to the narrator and he gestured the narrator to, he was asking the narrator to keep him back, take him in his arms. I was amazed at how heavy he was for his size. He was really amazed to see how heavy the gorilla was. His light chocolate colored fur was thick and soft. The chocolate colored fur, what was the color of the fur of the gorilla, children? It was chocolate colored. It was thick and it was soft. And his skin also on the hands, feet and face was soft. So if you touch a gorilla, you come to know that it would be soft. And it was glossy as leather. What do you mean by glossy, children? Glossy means something that shines. You make your projects on glossy paper, right? The glossy paper is very shiny. In the same way, the gorilla skin was very shiny. His eyes were small, deep set, twinkling like chips of coal. So his eyes were very small. They were twinkling like chips of coal. He lay back in my arms and studied me carefully with an unwinking stare. So he laid back in his arms and studied him carefully in an unwinking stare and then lifted a fat and gentle forefinger and touched my beard. So he touched the beard of the narrator. I tickled his ribs and he wriggled about in my arms, giggling hoarsely, his eyes shining with amusement. So What do you mean by hoarsely, children, in a rough way? So what did the narrator do? He tickled the gorilla. I sat him down on a convenient table and handed him a banana. So what did the narrator give to the gorilla to eat? He gave him banana to eat. He accepted it with little growls of pleasure and ate very daintily. So he accepted the pleasure very happily. He accepted and he was eating daintily. Compared to the chimpanzees who were stuffing their mouth full as they could. So now this gorilla was taking small bits of the banana and was eating the banana. He was not gobbling over the banana. He was eating it very daintily. Daintily means in a very careful way, using small steps or small movements. I wrote out the check and then we bundled and Pongo, growling protest, back into the crate and went off to catch the plane for Jersey. Okay, so then they went over to catch the plane for Jersey. So children, up till now we have seen that the narrator seems to be a person who is very fond of animals. Okay, now he has gone to London in order to take his name because the dealer has kept the name. Kept the gorilla in a room at Royal Society for the prevention of cruelty to animals. And therefore he has gone to see. Now the friendship between the gorilla and the narrator is very nice. So now what are they doing? They are going back to Jersey. Jersey is an island that is a part of a Channel Island near the coast of British Isles. So Jersey is the place, it's an island where the narrator lives. At Jersey, I took N. Pongo out of his coat as we drove to the zoo with him sitting on my lap. So now he has taken the gorilla out of his crate and where is he sitting, children? He is sitting on the lap of the narrator while he is driving to the zoo. He took a great interest in the cows as we passed, only occasionally looking up to peer into my face. So, he was really taking a lot of interest in seeing what are the things all around. He took a lot of interest in the cows which were passing by. When we arrived, I carried him to our flat. His cage was not ready and I had decided that he would have to spend a couple of days in our guest room. So, his cage was not ready in the guest room. In the zoo. And that is why the narrator decided that gorilla would stay in the guest room of narrator's house. His grave, courteous manner and his rather sad expression evenly won over both Jackie and my mother. So children, I think the narrator stays with Jackie and mother. So even these people also liked gorilla a lot. And before he was lying back on the sofa while they stuffed him with food. He was happily lying on the sofa while they were stuffing him with food. The staff too came upstairs one by one to pay homage to him as if he were a king. So now the staff of the zoo also came to his house to see the gorilla because everybody was so thrilled that a gorilla is going to join them. That is why this narrator is very... The people from the zoo, the staff of the zoo also came to narrator's house to take a look at the gorilla. So children, with whom is narrator staying? Narrator is staying with Jackie and his mother. Jackie and mother are stuffing gorilla with a lot of food and he is sitting there like a king. Okay. When they were driving over, what things was the gorilla interested? Gorilla was interested in the cows who were passing by when the narrator was driving. So why will the gorilla stay? Children, why will the gorilla stay in the guest house? In the guest room of narrator's home? Because the cage for gorilla is not ready. The cage in the zoo in which he will be kept is not yet ready. That's why the narrator has decided that he will stay in the guest house of the narrator. Children, this lesson is one thing, but it has really given me a thought. Shouldn't we be kind to animals? Yes, we should be very kind to animals. because animals are also a creation of God just like us. So the narrator seems to be very, very kind to the gorilla. He makes him sit on his lap, he feeds him banana, he takes him back to his house. So children, in the next module we will see the story of gorilla further. We will see how he gets famous in the zoo and what are the naughty things that the gorilla does in the zoo. Thank you for listening.